Hello friends, welcome to my channel Data Making. Please subscribe to my channel to get more technology videos. Okay, this is the continuation to our project video series, which is Apache Spark project to build a real-time stream processing system. Okay, which is actually the we get the stream data from meetup.com as a RSV JSON message, which is please reply message. So if somebody is hosting a event on their meetup group, okay, they post that event details in the meetups group. Okay, so the people can go and provide the RSVP, which is like either they want to attend the event, the meetup, okay, they'll say yes or no or maybe. Okay, so the meetup.com actually provides that the RSVP data as a streaming API. Okay, so it's a JSON API, it's open source, kind of it's available to public. Okay, so you can go and consume that REST API and get the data for your analysis. Okay, so basically this is the REST API URL, http /stream.meetup.com/2/RSVPS. Okay, so example, if you just run this, so it will start streaming your RSVP JSON data. Okay, so you can go and consume the data, okay, for your processing. So what we are doing in this video, I'm going to explain you about how we can actually consume this data and push it to the Kafka topic. So we are going to write a Kafka producer. Okay, so this before going to the Kafka producer code, I want to explain you the JSON structure. Okay, this is the RSVP JSON structure. So you will have the main field as a venue, which will have nested field like venue name and latitude longitude of that venue and venue ID. Okay, then you will have visibility, response. We are actually more interested on the response, which gives whether people is going to attend or no or maybe. Okay, so and you will have other fields like member, which will have member name, member ID, and event details. Okay, what is the event that is going to happen? Okay, and also the group details. Okay, so all this are this is almost a nested JSON structure. Okay, we are going to consume this JSON message and push it to the Kafka topic. Okay, let us jump into the Kafka producer code. Okay, so I written a Kafka producer code using Python. Okay, so basically you need to install a package called Kafka Python. Okay, so this is the Python package name, you need to install it. So I'm going to run this program in PyCharm IDE. If your people are not aware of PyCharm IDE, it's an integrated development environment for developing a Python projects. Okay, Python or PySpark project you can develop. Okay, so if you want to set up, if you want to know how to set up this PyCharm, I added a link in the description of this video. Please check it. I already prepared the video. You can just go and check it and you can set up on your local machine. Okay, so this is the one package you needed. So basically, let me go through this program. Okay, so what I'm doing is importing few Python packages. Okay, which is time for just for displaying time, as well as I want to stop this program execution for certain seconds, so I can use the second time start sleep to wait this program for some duration. Okay, and request package is basically used for making a REST API calls, post and get methods, if you HTTP to make the HTTP REST APIs. So so you know REST APIs has different methods like get, post and put method. So as I told you, the meetup.com provides a REST API for stream data. Okay, to consume the stream data. So this is the so request package, we are going to use it. And Kafka producer is the class, which is class or module, which is in the Kafka package. So this is actually provides you the client or connector for talking to the Kafka broker or server. Okay, so you need to import the Kafka producer from the Kafka package, and JSON you need to import the JSON package, which we are going to do some JSON manipulation. Okay, a kind of parsing and things like that. Okay, so first thing is you need to have the URL, which is REST API URL for consuming the stream data. Okay, which is http://stream.meetup.com/2/RSVPS. This is the REST endpoint or URL to consume the stream data. And once you consume the data, you are going to push it to the Kafka topic. Okay, I have a single node Kafka cluster in my system. Okay, so basically I already set up. If you want to know how to set up, I just added in the environment setup video. I just given all the links. Please go through the previous video and set up your environment, your local machine. Okay, so we need a Kafka topic where we want to publish this JSON RSVP meetup RSVP JSON message. So the topic I am using is a meetup RSVP topic. Okay, so Bootstrap server. What is Bootstrap server? It's a Kafka broker or Kafka server, which is running on certain machine with port number 9092, which is a default port number. So you need to, so because my Kafka is running on my local machine, I just given localhost colon 9092, which is a default port number. That's a Bootstrap server. Okay, now this is the entry point of the Python program, any Python program, where you see the if underscore underscore main equal to underscore under, sorry, if underscore underscore name underscore underscore equal to, in double quotation, if you see the underscore underscore main underscore underscore, this is the entry point of the Python program. Basically, this code will run whenever the program run directly. The Kafka underscore producer underscore demo is a program. .py is a Python program. So if you run directly, only this code will run. If you are making this program as a module, then if you are calling this module from this program, if you are making as a module, and if you are trying to call from other program, Python program, then this code will not run. Okay, so only the methods and properties we can access, but not this piece of code. So this program I am going to run program directly. So I written all this code in the main itself. Okay, so what I am going to do is I'm just printing the some text message like Python producer application started. I am going to create a Python the Kafka producer object. Okay, which is used to publish the message to the Kafka topic. So I need to provide the Bootstrap server, and then I am actually giving the serializer. Okay, what does the serializer mean? So basically, in Kafka topic, whatever you publish the message, we are going to publish as a key value pair. Key is basically a topic, and value is actually the JSON message you are going to publish. Okay, that's how you are going to send the message to the topic. Okay, so if you want, you need to serialize your object. Okay, so basically I am going to serialize into the JSON message as a JSON JSON formatted message, which is of encoding UTF-8. Okay, so that's what I am, when you creating producer itself, I am creating the serializer object. So once this Kafka producer object is created, now what I am going to do is I am going to create a while loop, which is an infinite loop. Okay, so in this infinite loop, what I am going to do is I am going to run this run method, which is basically get method with the REST API URL. Okay, so once you request.get and provide the URL and stream equal to 2, so it's going to consume the REST API and pull the JSON messages. So once you once this line of code runs, it will actually fetch the set of JSON message. So that will be in the stream API response object. So this will have one or multiple JSON messages. So what you are going to do is, if the response status code is 200, which is a success HTTP request, okay, then we are going to process that response API response. If the request code is 200 only, we are going to put, means that is a success REST API call. So what I am going to do, response dot the stream underscore API underscore respond dot iter underscore lines, which is going to give you the list of messages, JSON messages in the the response object. Okay, so iterating each element, okay, each message. Okay, I'm going to check what is the messages type. So basically it will actually giving as a string, even though it is a JSON format, it is going to give us a string. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to convert as a the dish JSON object, okay, which is kind of dictionary, you can say. Because if I directly send the as a string message, the basically the in the consumer side, which is a Spark structured streaming application, it's not able to serialize deserialize properly, or you can say parsing is not happening. Why? Because no parsing not happening in the Spark structured streaming. I'm using a from JSON object, which is actually used to parse your JSON. A properly formatted JSON message. Okay, so I'll tell you when we talk about Spark structure streaming. So basically what you need to do is you need to send the proper JSON structure message. So that's the reason the string, whatever the message it comes from the response stream API response, I convert into JSON object. Okay, then what we do is we actually to check whether the once it is converted to JSON object, I'm just checking what is the type of it. So basically if you see first the message, it will be string, then it will show the dictionary as a dictionary. So then that message we are actually sending it to the Kafka topic using the producer object. The producer object dot send send, you have two properties for this send method. One is a topic name comma the response the JSON message. Okay, so every message I'm actually putting sleep for 1 second, because if continuously running, so some it has to make the API call and publish the message to the topic, right? It needs some lagging, because otherwise it is actually not publishing properly. So I just introduced a 1 second delay. Okay, so it will actually send the data to the Kafka topic. So it will actually convert into the UTF 8 encoding string, and it will send it to the Kafka topic. So it will be a properly JSON formatted data. Okay, so but it will be in the string format, that sure. Okay, so then what we are going to do is so basically this I put it in the try catch, so that any exception comes, this will just display the message and it will actually run for the next iteration. So once the API request, it makes API request and get this set of JSON message, and it publishes the top topic, and it will actually go, it will run for infinite loop, because we put while true. Okay, so we have given any, didn't give any condition, so it always run for infinite times. Okay, so this is the I can say it's a I cannot say it's very simple, it's most of it simple only. So basically it's if people you are already aware of Python and all this distributed messaging system, it is very easy. People who are new to this, you will actually understand. Once if you go through this code, you will understand. So let me run this program and I'll show you. So before running this program, let me run my Kafka broker, which is a Kafka server. So to start our Kafka server, we need to start the Kafka the ZooKeeper component. Okay, because ZooKeeper component is used for coordination service. So ZooKeeper service started, it is running on the default port number 2181. So I'm going to run the Kafka server. So you navigate to the installation location, which is this location. So I'll run the Kafka server. So when the Kafka server is running, okay, so I'm going to basically publish this message. Okay, publish the message into this topic, which topic is basically this meetup RSVP topic. Okay, so I already created the topic. Okay, so I'll just run the command line consumer from this topic, so that whenever we produce we push the data to the topic, we'll be able to see the message which is getting consumed in the command line. For this, for verification or testing purpose, so I'll run this. Okay, so it is going to solve the, so I just given the previous message, coming all the previous message. Let me stop this. Yeah, I just give the, I will not provide this from beginning, means whatever the message is published on this topic, it will actually display. So I don't want to do that. I will want to get only the latest message. Okay, so now it is waiting for the message on this command line consumer. So basically Kafka provides a command line consumer and producer for this for testing purpose. So we will use the command line consumer. So we'll now run our the Kafka producer, okay, which is going to consume the messages from this REST API, stream REST API for stream data. Okay, it is going to publish into the topic. Okay, now it is started. See, if you see, initially it is coming as a string, then I am converting into JSON object, which is a dictionary, and I am pushing it to the Kafka topic. So now we can see here, this is a command line consumer which we are running. So what are the message it is publishing here? So you are seeing here, it's on real time. Okay, so this is the very good Apache Kafka is a very good component for your to use your messaging system. It's a kind of intermediate buffer, you can say. Okay, so I hope this video is helpful, and if you understood the points which I want to cover it. So basically, so what we are doing is we are using a PyCharm IDE, and we are writing a Kafka producer to consume the consume the message from the meetup stream API, the REST API, and then publish it to the Kafka topic, which is the meetup KS RSVP topic. This, okay. So in the next module or the next video, we are going to see how to consume this data using a Spark structure streaming and do the processing. Okay, so I hope this video is helpful to you. Thank you so much for watching this video. See in the next video. Please subscribe to my channel, and so basically I added so many videos in my channel, so on different technologies like Spark, Hadoop, and machine learning, other stuff. I have other project videos as well in my playlist. You can just go and watch it, and if you have any doubt, you can post it. I'll try to help you out. Definitely I'll respond to all your messages. Please support me in my channel. Thank you so much, friends.